once you get a mandolin, you're going to need a strap for it, especially if you're going to stand up and play it. There are, well, a couple of ways. I guess there's many, many ways. There's two major ways, and I'm going to use a guitar strap to demonstrate, but I play, have my strap over my shoulder, like this, versus like this. Or, I mean, like having this around the curl. Mandolin is a little more difficult. You know, guitar, you just get the, you pop these into the end pins. There's a personality of the strap, what it's going to look like. There's also a personality on the way you're going to play it, because, and I think my dad probably started me on this, I don't know, or I may have seen Bill Monroe play, and he had it over his shoulder, and he pulled the mandolin up into the microphone. And for whatever reason, I started doing that, and that's the way I play. The mandolin, you've got a curl to deal with usually, or if you have an A-style mandolin, you might have to have a button put on there. Anyway, we're here to select a strap. We're at Bruin Guitars. We have all these different straps. If there's the guitar straps, and you come down here to the mandolin straps. And they have this that would fit over the curl of the mandolin. You could, well, no, I guess it just fits over that. And there's an end pin at the end. So that's one style of strap that you could have. Some of them have, like this, you tie it up there. Same sort of principle. But a strap is like, number one, I would get something that's, it has to be secure, first of all. You don't want the mandolin to drop, to fall. So it has to be secure. And then it has to be comfortable. So you don't want something that's going to be scratchy or could, you know, scratch up your instrument. So usually when they make a strap, they're very conscious of that. However, I ended up finding my straps that I use have been custom made because I found a Swarovski crystal belt. And it was so beautiful. And I said, oh my goodness, Jenny Guttrumson is the one who makes my straps. And I said, I wonder if she could make a strap out of this. And she did. So beautiful. Oh my goodness. There's many colors. There are some that are braided. This, I think, is the guys. This is usually a favorite of theirs. More the something that's not as, for a mandolin, they usually, for me, to get something that's thin, it will cut into my shoulder. And it's not comfortable. By the time, by the end of the show, it will have made an impression. So, because I've tried that before. So I like a wider leather, not flimsy. I like something that's pretty pretty secure or a thicker leather. But it depends on what you want. So I would suggest go to the store and look at all the straps. Maybe bring your mandolin and put it on there. Or if you buy it, just come over and select a strap. There's different personalities. Or you can call somebody. There's a lot of different people who make mandolin straps or make guitar straps. Leather toolers, like Jenny. She's, by trade, she's a leather tooler. So she makes them. She can put the Swarovski crystals on there. She's made so many of them, and I'll show you those. Sit down here for this and see what I can do. Hey guys, if you like this clip, please subscribe to my page right here. And if you want to see longer versions of what you just watched, well, head to countryroadtv.com and use the code Rhonda when signing up to get 30 days free. And to see more of the Country Road community, be sure and check out my friend Ronnie Reno on his YouTube channel. I'll see you next time.